The impeachment trial of President Trump is nearing its halfway point. 100 United States senators listened today to prosecutors from the House of Representatives taking turns as they sought to wrap up their case. Once again, Nick Schifrin begins our coverage.
Today, House Democrats are ending their opening arguments the way they began, portraying President Trump as a clear and present danger.
The president's scheme to pressure Ukraine to do his political dirty work harmed our national security, undermined our free and fair elections, and even today, threatens the very foundation of our democracy.
Lead House Manager Adam Schiff and a half dozen other Democrats focused today on the second article of impeachment, obstruction of Congress. Quote, in the history of the Republic, no president has ever ordered the complete defiance of an impeachment inquiry or sought to obstruct and impede so comprehensively the ability of the House of Representatives to investigate high crimes and misdemeanors. New York Democrat Hakeem Jeffries.
President Trump tried to cheat. He got caught. And then he worked hard to cover it up.
They argued that cover-up began on July the 10th. When administration officials told visiting Ukrainian officials that Ukraine would have to investigate the 2016 election and Joe Biden and his son Hunter Biden before getting a coveted White House meeting. On July 25th, President Trump spoke to Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky and repeated the investigation requests. And in August, an intelligence official working at the White House filed a whistleblower complaint. Today, House Manager Jason Crow said the White House covered up each step.
It started with the White House's lawyers' failure to stop the scheme after the July 10th meeting was reported to them, continued with attempts to hide the July 25th call summary, and escalated with the White House's illegal concealment of the whistleblower complaint from Congress.
During the investigation, Democrats subpoenaed and asked for documents from Secretary of State Mike Pompeo, Acting White House Chief of Staff Mick Mulvaney, and National Security Council lawyer John Eisenberg. All refused to comply, even though Eisenberg knew of internal concerns about the president's actions.
Because the president blocked Mr. Eisenberg from testifying without any justification, the record is silent as to what, if any, actions he or the White House counsel took to address President Trump's brazen misconduct and abuse of power.
President Trump has argued there was no cover-up because nearly $400 million in military aid to Ukraine was eventually released. But Democrats today said it was released only under pressure.
After the House launched an investigation, and after Congress learned about the existence of a whistleblower complaint, the $391 million in security aid was only released because President Trump was caught red-handed.
Today, President Trump portrayed the Democrats as tedious, writing on Twitter, "The do-nothing Democrats just keep repeating and repeating over and over again the same old stuff on the impeachment hoax. They want to use up all of their time, even though it is the wrong thing to do. They ought to go back to work for our great American people." That was echoed by Nebraska Republican Deb Fischer during an interview with Judy Woodruff.
It was wrong of the president to ask the president of Ukraine to conduct an investigation into Vice President Biden and his son. Do you accept their premise that that is what President Trump did?
I don't. You know, I'm waiting to hear from the defense starting tomorrow. That's what a jury's supposed to do. We don't make decisions based on one side presentation. And we'll hear what the president's defense says tomorrow.
In the Senate, there are 47 Democrats and independents. 20 Republicans would have to join them to get to two-thirds, 67, to convict the president and remove him from office. But only four Republicans would have to switch to get to a majority of 51 to allow witnesses and new evidence. Today, Senate Minority Leader Chuck Schumer made that appeal personal.
Will four Republican senators, just four, rise to the occasion, do their duty, to their Constitution, to their country, to seek the truth?
The Democrats also focused today on former U.S. Ambassador to Ukraine, Marie Yovanovitch. She testified how she was dismissed by the Director General of the Foreign Service in a hurry.
She said I needed to get on come home immediately, get on the next plane to the U.S.
And today we learn more about how long President Trump had been discussing her removal. 1 year before she was dismissed, President Trump was having dinner with Lev Parnas and Igor Fruman, associates of his attorney, Rudy Giuliani. They were criticizing her, and according to a recording heard by ABC News, President Trump said, "Get rid of her. Get her out tomorrow. Take her out, okay? Do it." Today, Republicans argued ambassadors serve at the president's pleasure, and that President Trump was well within his power to fire an ambassador, as he had fired so many would-be apprentices.
You're fired.
My guess is we're probably not surprised that the guy who, you know, had a TV show where he talked about firing people is willing to recall the ambassador. The President of the United States can put in place the people he thinks who are best there to, who would do the best job implementing the policies that he was elected to implement. I think that's what he's doing.
During this trial, senators are supposed to sit silently at their desks. But in this chamber-turned-courtroom, the days are long and the chairs are hard. Sketch artist Bill Hennessy caught a fidgety senator's desk left empty, a notepad left behind, a fidget spinner in another senator's hands, and another on a nearby desk. During a break, Republicans strategized. The president's side will begin its turn tomorrow, when they start up to 24 hours of opening arguments and try to rebut Democrats' central argument.
There's a toxic mess at 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue, and I humbly suggest that it's our collective job on behalf of the American people to try to clean it up.
For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Nick Schifrin.
And now to share their reporting on this ongoing trial, our own Lisa Desjardins at the Capitol and Yamiche Alcindor at the White House. Hello to both of you. So, Lisa, you were watching it all, and you were telling us that you're seeing something new today in terms of how these senators are taking it in.
That's right. From our spot above the Senate chamber, generally above the Republican side of the chamber, I have to tell you, Judy, I saw for the first time today every single senator taking notes or looking through the graphic presentation in paper form that Democrats had given out. Up until today, Republicans had been given the choice whether to get that presentation in paper form or not. Some Republicans have chosen not to look at it. And I had seen several senators who were watching and listening, but not taking notes, not looking through any paperwork. Today, these desks are full of documents, every single one of them. Also, Judy, did not see a single senator nodding off. And I know that's kind of a funny thing to talk about, but these are long days. The chairs are hard, as Nick wrote, and it's very common to see, for brief moments, senators nodding off. Did not see that today. I think this is an alert Senate. Why is this? Speaking to senators, there's two factors. I think there's anticipation of the president side presenting his case very soon, and people are focusing on getting ready, preparing for that. I also think there's a lot of consideration of the questions senators will get to ask once the president rests his case in his opening statements, and senators are starting to hone in on that fact that they will get the chance to ask questions. They're trying to sort out what they want to ask.
And to Yamiche, you've obviously been talking to the White House. How are they? How is the president responding to what's going on today and in these other days? And there's this new recording of the president?
That's right, Judy. President Trump and the president's legal team has spent most of the day lashing out at Democrats, saying that they are really after the president for this partisan political act. I've been texting with Rudy Giuliani again today. He's been telling me that there are too many lies to push back on. So his take is that Democrats are really making things up. Of course, Democrats disagree with his statements there. But then there's this new recording of President Trump that appears to show him saying a year before Marie Yovanovitch, the former ambassador to Ukraine, was fired, a year before that, saying, "Get rid of her." Now, I've been talking to Lev Parnas's attorney. He's an associate with Rudy Giuliani's, who's facing federal charges. His lawyer says this bolsters his client's claim that President Trump was engaged in this scheme to get Marie Yovanovitch out of the way so that he could pressure Ukraine to investigate Joe Biden. The lawyer also says that this new recording shows that there needs to be more evidence and more witnesses added to the Senate trial. Of course, President Trump has been pushing back on this. The White House is saying, of course, that the president can do whatever he wants. But the president also attacked Marie Yovanovitch while she was testifying, famously saying that she was someone who was a bad ambassador and everywhere she went turned bad.
Lisa, back to you. On this was the day when Democrats turned to the second article of impeachment. It really wasn't until mid to late afternoon before they got around to the second article, which has to do with obstruction of Congress. What are you hearing unfold in that regard?
Right, and we saw this on the floor very clearly. Democrats produced letters, some from officials within the executive department, some from the Department of Defense specifically, saying to House impeachment at that time chairman that they wanted to comply. They were trying to help them get documents, but eventually they were ordered not to submit those documents. Also, they were showing letters from individuals and attorneys that were saying, my client has no choice but to follow the direct orders of his boss, President Trump. And Democrats sort of summed it up, Zoe Lofgren summed it up as saying that the president's orders were indiscriminate, categorical, and they were wrong, and that that shows obstruction. Another interesting note, Zoe Lofgren, a lot of times we're talking about Adam Schiff, but I spoke to a few senators today that say Zoe Lofgren of California actually is reaching through to senators in a way, in a sort of a plain-spoken way that seems to be having an effect on both sides. Now, what will they do the rest of the night, Judy? By my calculation, as of dinner time here in Washington, the Democrats have about 3 hours remaining of that 24 hours. Can you believe we're already nearly at the end of it? And we'll see if they continue with these arguments. I also am looking, though, for the personal stories of these managers talking about why they care so much and their own personal histories. That was one of the most effective parts of the House impeachment hearings back last year.
Oh, so interesting, and we'll all be listening for that tonight. In the meantime, finally, Yamiche, starting tomorrow, it's the turn of the president's legal team. They're going to have up to 24 hours, up to 3 days. What do we know that we can expect so far?
I forgot the graphics. I knew there's something I forgot.
Well, a source working on the president's legal team says that they're eager to present the rebuttal to the Democrats' case. A quick note on the president's tweet, a tweet that the president sent out. He said, my lawyers will be forced to start on Saturday, which is called Death Valley in TV. Essentially, the president's saying, look, I don't like the fact that we have to present our case, not in prime time. That said, the president's lawyers say that they're going to take about 3 hours tomorrow to have what they call a trailer. They say it's a coming attractions trailer, saying that they're going to preview some of their arguments, but not make the bulk of their arguments until Monday. And then on Monday, they say that's the main attraction. They're using these words that are kind of Hollywood words. And of course, the president had a pretty successful TV show, so we can see where that language is coming from. But they're saying that they're going to start rebutting the Democrats and that they're going to talk a lot about Joe Biden and make the case that the president was right to bring up Joe Biden. And they say that they're doing that in part because Democrats spent a lot of time defending Joe Biden. So we're going to see a pretty large and expansive defense by the president's attorneys.
Well, we are going to remain on the edge of our seats. Yamiche Alcindor at the White House, Elisa Desjardins at the Capitol, and we'll be seeing you tonight. And you can join our ongoing coverage of the Senate trial for the remainder of the evening. Check your local listings for that and online on our website or on YouTube. And again, tomorrow, Saturday, when, as you heard, the trial resumes at 10 a.m. Eastern.